Beauty begins the moment you decide to be yourself. Info Booth 19. Today we are going to see one interesting recipe, which is brinjal gravy or brinjal chutney. It is going to be a thick gravy type, which will be a side dish for chapati, roti, dosa, idli, or even you can have with rice. It's a very spicy and very good dish. Whoever loves brinjal will love this recipe for sure. So let's get into the recipe, how to prepare this. So to prepare this brinjal gravy, so I have taken here 1/2 kg to 750 grams of brinjal. So if you see, just take the fresh brinjal, it's a farm fresh, then cut into slices and put in water to avoid it from becoming black in color. So you have to, as soon as you cut, you have to put the brinjal in water with a pinch of salt in that. So this we will do the preparation and keep it aside. For this kind of this much amount, so these are the quantities. So 2 big size onion I have taken, you should finely chop and keep it. And then 1 small piece of lemon, half lemon size tamarind, you can soak in water and keep. And then salt, turmeric powder. And to prepare the dry masala, we are going to fry these ingredients and make it as a masala powder. For that I have taken 5 to 6 Kashmiri chili, which doesn't give more spiciness but give color. And then 4 to 5 red chili, 2 tablespoon tur dal, 2 tablespoon chana dal, and 2 tablespoon urad dal, and 2 tablespoon of coriander seeds, 1 tablespoon jeera, and 1 tablespoon curry leaf. So these are the ingredients which we are going to fry and then powder it well. And then hing I have used 1 tablespoon. So first, to prepare this, what we are going to do is, in a pan, just take 1 tablespoon of gingerly oil. Prepare this dish in gingerly oil, it gives more taste and it's very healthy as well. So in that, first I'm going to add all the 3 types of dal, because it takes more time to fry. So first we are adding that. So once the dal becomes slightly golden color, so we are going to add this coriander seeds and jeera as well. Keep the flame at very low, do not burn the masala, then the gravy will not be good. So once the coriander and jeera gets fried, then we are going to add this dry red chili, Kashmiri chili, and the dry red chili as per the spiciness taste, however you want. And then curry leaves, and then 1 tablespoon of hing. So mix it well, and once it gets fried, turn off the stove and transfer it to a mixer jar. Once it gets cooled down, you can grind it to a fine powder. So since we are grinding the masala fresh and we are preparing this, it will be very tasty and it smells amazing. So you will like it. In the same pan, I have added 1 tablespoon of gingerly oil again, and I'm going to fry this brinjal pieces, whatever we have cut, and put in water. So we are not going to add anything to it. Just fry the brinjal pieces in the oil itself. In between, you just keep frying so that it will not get burnt. Otherwise, only in one side it will become very much brown color. So keep mixing in between. So we are going to fry it till all the sides it's become golden color, and it has to get cooked as well. So in between, you can close the lid and cook as well. Now if you see, it have become brown color, but still another 2 to 3 minutes we have to cook. Keep the flame at low at this point. Now we are going to turn off the stove. It has become completely brown and nicely cooked. So we are going to add it in the mixer jar. Give it 1 pulse and take it. Do not grind it completely. We need little bit pieces of brinjal when we eat the gravy, so that it gives a good taste. So we'll transfer this brinjal into the mixer jar, and we'll give just 1 whip and take and keep aside. So this gravy, you can keep in fridge for 3 to 4 days, and you can have as a pickle type or a side dish. You can have with roti. In case if you're going for a trip or if you're traveling, this is the best combination. You can prepare chapati and you can take it. It will be very tasty. And then so once we prepare everything, now we will start making this gravy. So in a pan, I have added 2 to 3 tablespoons of gingerly oil, and then mustard seed, little bit of urad dal, curry leaves, and dry red chili. So this is for tadka. Just mix it well, fry it nicely. Then we are going to add the whipped brinjal paste. So once we add this, we can add the onion as well. Finely chop the onions and add the onion as well along with the brinjal pieces. And just cook it for 3 to 4 minutes on medium-high flame. So all the raw smell of brinjal and onion should go. Till that point, we need to fry it well and take it. It will take a little bit of extra time, 4 to 5 minutes. But keep the flame at low and keep mixing in between. So it has to get fried nicely and come. Then after that, we will start adding all the masalas. So once the raw smell of onion and brinjal goes, we are going to add the masala, salt and turmeric powder. So when you're adding the masala, make sure you keep the flame on very, very lower side. Otherwise, it will get burnt at the bottom. So once you add the masala, add some half glass of water so that it will not get burnt at the bottom. And also the masala gets into the brinjal mix very well. Add all the masalas. Now mix it well. Now close the lid and cook for around 3 to 4 minutes so that all gets incorporated well and the oil should get separated on the sides. Till that point we need to cook it. If you see, now oil has separated from the sides. It has taken like 3 to 4 minutes. Now mix it really well and then we are going to add the tamarind water. So once you add the tamarind water, mix it well. Then we can add a half tablespoon of jaggery, which is an optional step. But if you add jaggery, this tamarind and salt will get combined and it will give a very great taste to the dish. So we are going to cook this till the raw smell of tamarind goes and the oil gets separated on the sides. It will take 2 to 3 minutes again. The more we fry, more we cook, the gravy becomes very tasty and it is very spicy, and you can adjust the spiciness as per your taste. At this point, you can check for salt, and if you need more salt, you can add. And after some 4 to 5 minutes, if you see the oil has separated from the side, our brinjal gravy is ready. It's a very great combination for roti, chapati, and then for dosa, idli and all. And you can even pack curd rice and you can take this as side dish and go. It is very, very tasty. It is very good lunchbox recipe. And if you're traveling, you instead of like generally we take this tomato chutney, tomato gravy for roti, instead of this you can try this with brinjal. Everyone will love it for sure. Whoever likes brinjal, it would be their favorite, one of the favorite dish. If you like this recipe, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and share the link with your friends and family. If you try this dish, share the dish photo to the email ID given below. And always be happy, stay positive, keep your surroundings happy and spread the positive energy around. Have a great day.